What one thing can you point out that the Democrats, that Leader Schumer, what one thing did he get, you know, from Republicans to justify shutting down the government in the first place?
So the one thing I would say that he did get is the potential for momentum. Because if, and I'm certainly hopeful that's what occurs, but if the majority leader, Mr. McConnell, can be taken at his word, and over the next 3 weeks before February 8th, they can negotiate on protecting the Dreamers, on making sure that we can have a full year comprehensive budget that lifts the caps and really makes sure that we can responsibly
budget again, then maybe we can
be in a position to get the House and the President to come on board.
I'm still hung up, though, and I know Americans are listening, and they heard you say, and it's reverberating, potential for momentum, and they're thinking, potential for momentum, was that really worth shutting the government down for? The potential for something.
I will tell you that Republicans should be asking themselves that question because they shut the government down. This is a Trump shutdown, Brooke. They control the White House, the House, and the Senate. They have the full ability to have passed a budget, done whatever they wanted, and they couldn't because they know that the way they are trying to approach funding the government is irresponsible, and they couldn't even get all of their own members to vote for it. There is a potential for momentum if they are able to reach agreement on making sure that we can have a comprehensive budget deal, get our disaster relief passed to protect the communities that have been devastated by natural disasters, make sure we responsibly fund our military, our community health centers, and children's health insurance, and our Dreamers. And then eventually, hopefully, we can get some agreement from the House and the President. My concern is that this is an exclusively Senate deal. The House and the White House have had, you know, no part of this. And so the momentum is what I'm hopeful about. And, you know, we'll just have to wait and see. But so, I can't vote yes on wait and see.
Understand. And on the potential for momentum, let's go with that argument. And then on that, do you think that Senate Democrats should trust Mitch McConnell and his promise, his intention to deal with this in 3 weeks?
I'm not a Senate Democrat, so I can't judge what a Senate Democrat should or should not be doing. I am a House Democrat, and I can tell you that there's no trust here on the House side because there's been none earned. The Republican leadership in the House has not been included in this deal, was not asked to sign off, and actually over the weekend when Paul Ryan was asked to sign off, he said no. And so the bill that I'll have in front of me has no confirmation from me and my comfort level that even if they get momentum, that the House will take it up or that the President will sign it. So this Trump shutdown is purely a result of their ineptitude, their inability to govern, and the madness has to stop. And it's only going to stop if we sit down at the table, work together, hammer out a compromise on the variety of issues that are absolutely essential to the American people's quality of life.
On that word compromise, I was talking to one of your colleagues in the House, Luis Gutierrez, over the weekend in D.C., and, you know, I know several Democrats, him included, you know, they say they actually support building the wall, you know, give the president his big, beautiful wall in exchange for Dreamer help.
I sat next to Luis Gutierrez in caucus today. He doesn't support the wall, so don't characterize it that way.
He sat with me, Congresswoman, in the D.C. Bureau on Saturday saying, give me a hammer and nails, I will build that wall
I'm
myself
telling you, but
if
he
I
doesn't,
get protection
right.
for
he
Dreamers.
He said he was willing to compromise on it, but let's not characterize that as support for the wall. None of us, I don't know any Democrat that supports this wall, and most Republicans don't support it. But what we do need to do to protect 800,000 Dreamers who were brought to this country through no fault of their own is sit down together at the table and have a discussion and a comprehensive compromise legislation that we can put on the floor that both houses will sign off on and the president will sign into law. And if that ultimately in that discussion includes, you know, some version of a wall, then if it's the bipartisan will to do that, then that's something that should be considered. But I'm not going to cherry pick, you know, every part of what could be considered to reach a deal to protect our Dreamers. I just want to make sure that we're sitting down together at the table and talking about achieving that. And thus far, the Republicans on the House side in particular have been unwilling to do that.
Sure. Well, 87% of the country agrees with you on protecting the Dreamers. So there's that. Congresswoman Debbie Wasserman Schultz, good to see you. Thank you very much.
Thanks.